Hey guys, Marisa at kitchentablestamper.com. I have got the cutest little box for you today. It holds the fun size Kit Kats. You can get them in white and you can get them in milk. And look at this cute little box. It's also a sneak peek for the Hello Ladybug Stamp-A-Stack class that's coming. So let me give you a quick sneak peek at those cards, then we'll get started with this project. The Stamp-A-Stack will be on the blog May 2nd, 3rd, and 4th, and the class packets, optional, available while supplies last, will be in the Kitchen Table Stamper store on Monday the 2nd. All right, so our Stamp-A-Stack, Hello Ladybug Stamp-A-Stack, coming soon, here's your sneak peek, makes two of this card, three of this design, and three of this design. So you're gonna stamp an awesome stack of cards, and that begins May 2nd on the blog. Now here's our little coordinated treat. This is our coffee and a mystery, not a card, in the Craft Social. So there's something going on everywhere at Kitchen Table Stamper. If you don't know the Craft Social, it's our Facebook group, and the link is below. Let's start with the base of our box here, and I'm using Pool Party cardstock. This is 4 inches by 5 1/4. And we're gonna start on the 4-inch side. We're gonna score at 1/2 inch on both 4-inch sides. That gives us nice 1/2 inch no matter what we did in cutting our paper, a little long, a little short, a little whatever. We've got 1/2 inch sides for our box. That's why we do this. Let me show you the template, the picture that will be in the project sheet on the blog, kitchentablestamper.com, link to the project below. We're going to score this on the 5 1/4 inch side at 1 1/2, 2, 3 1/2, and 4. And then we're going to trim it up just like the template. Get a bone folder, some paper snips. I'm going to work my scores with the bone folder. I like to work them both ways just in case my cardstock is a little dry. Sometimes during the winter months, especially, your cardstock can dry out a bit. If it's dry, it can crack when you fold. And if you have any cracking, you want that on the inside of your box. So that's why I do that. A lot of people do ask. So once in a while, I like to, while I'm doing the folds, explain why I do that. There is a reason. All right, so we've got our box, and the orientation is so that the smaller, this more narrow panel is to the top. So you've got 1 1/2 inches here. You've got 1 1/4 inches here. You want that one on the top. And you're going to cut these two smaller rectangles out, turn these two squares into the inside tabs. So how we'll do that is we'll go down along the score line, cutting it off, and stop at the second intersecting score line. We'll cut off the rectangle at the first score line from the right side, and then we'll take a little angle cut out of that square tab, and we'll repeat that on the other side. All right, now that we've got that, let's liberate the bottom tabs of the box, and we're gonna do that by just cutting out the score line, so a tiny little triangle, nothing extreme. Stop at the first intersecting score line and just cut out those scores, making a small square tab for the bottom of the box. Do the same on the other side. And that is our little Kit Kat box. Let's do some details. We're going to round the corners on the flap, and we're going to add some designer series paper. Our designer series paper is from the 2021-2023 in-color designer series paper that is currently on sale in the last chance for $6.90, plus today is free shipping. Oh my goodness, what a great deal. Stock up on your designer series papers. The piece for our flap is 2 7/8 by 1 1/8, and we're rounding two of the corners. And then the piece for the front of our box, so underneath the flap, I've got two different patterns of the same fresh freesia color. This one is 2 7/8 by 1 3/8. Let's go ahead and adhere those to the box with liquid glue. The flap goes on the outside of the box here. The front panel goes on the outside of the box here, and you can center that right in. There's going to be a tiny little blue border all the way around our freesia designer series paper. Now let's get some tear and tape and put this box together. All right, I'm working from the inside of my box, and I'm going to put a little adhesive on the tab and then a little adhesive on the long side without the inside flaps. See? So there's our adhesive placement. It's going to take your pick tool and remove the adhesive liner. And we're going to do the little tabs first. Stay with me here because we're going to put them on the outside of the box. So we're going to bring in your tuck tab and then wrap this tab to the outside of the box and adhere. Now we're going to remove the liner on the long strip of adhesive. We're going to wrap this also outside the box but toward the back. So look, now the front flap goes to the back and seals that little tab to the inside. Our seams are all to the back of the box. And now there's nothing inside here for your treat to get stuck on. Have you ever had a treat box and as you're putting the treat in, the paper is getting all stuck on that little tab on the inside of the box? Well, this way method allows you to put the adhesive on the same side of the box and sandwich that little tab in so that it doesn't disrupt the function of our little treat box. So slide in nice and smooth. And get a nice finished look from the outside with these inside tabs. And there's our little Kit Kat box. Isn't that just the cutest thing? Now you could tie this closed with some ribbon. You could seal it shut with a little magnet or some Velcro. I'm going to use one of these Velcro tabs. I've got links for this all over my blog. I love these little Velcro tabs. I'll try to remember to put one in the description below. I get them on Amazon. I buy 6 packs of, I think, 56, and I just love it. All right, I'm going to take the fuzzy side and remove the liner. I'm going to put it right in the center of my tab and burnish. Then I'm going to remove the adhesive, the rough side of the Velcro, burnish down, take the two parts apart, and then burnish each piece individually. Now you've got a cute little treat box that opens and closes, and nobody has to remove ribbon or untie a bow to get to the treat. Isn't that just so much fun? All right, now it's just decorating. And this one I decorated over the top, especially for such a cute little box, but I love it. So let's do it anyway. We're going to use the Hello Ladybug Bundle. I am featuring this one pretty strongly in the beginning of May as we transition catalogs. I love this bundle. Let's do our wings first. So I've got Pool Party and my Stamparatus. On my Stamparatus, I have the little polka dots for the wings. I'm going to go ahead and put my cardstock right over. First, I stamp on my scratch paper so I can see where my image is going to stamp. Then I put my cardstock over. Now I can ink my spots and stamp. And if I want a darker impression, which I always do with something like these black dots, I can ink and stamp again. So we can do some repeat inking and still get our dots perfectly in the right place. I'm going to do a third time. That's pretty good, actually. 2 times was pretty good this time around. You can see, I don't really clean it in between. I'll clean it when I put it all away. But with the grid paper in here, and the way this just closes up and is all self-contained, there's no need, and you'll actually get a darker black image every time you come back to this. So if you're doing a lot of ladybugs, or if you're doing a lot of projects with the ladybugs, just leave it in the Stamparatus. All right, so now we gotta punch these guys out. Let's see if I... Oh, got to trim just a little bit. Kind of got a little excess on the end there to get this in the punch. But look how easy and how cute. We got these little beetle wings. And in Pool Party. Isn't that fun and out of the box? I was looking for a combination that would make the little ladybug look new. And it seems like everybody's doing it black and red. And then maybe with a little bit of... you know, granny apple green and some daffodil delight and white. I wanted to really get outside the box with this ladybug because these beetles can be cute in all different colors. So we punched our body from basic black. We're going to adhere our wings with some liquid glue. Give it a second to dry. Now I'm going to have a moment here of just do as I show you. Or as I tell you, not as I show you, because we have been making class packets for the Ladybug class, and I have lots of little bits left over. So from the salad bin, where I have all the bough and sprig punches and granny apple green and shaded spruce, I chose two of these already punched. This is granny apple green. I punched it with the bough punch using the sprig, and we've got two of them. The next thing I'm going to tell you about instead of show you again is more extra pieces from the class packet preparation. I got the little arrow for our greeting. This is the best little greeting piece, and it's from a brand new set. You're getting a sneak peek here. This is the He's All That bundle. It's coming in the next catalog, the 2022-2023 annual catalog. And the He's All That stamp set is a fantastic masculine set with tons of different themes. You've got that almost nautical navigation camping with the compass rose. Holy smokes, you're amazing with the barbecue tools, the surfboard and Volkswagen bus together for the long haul, classic cars, the handyman with the wrenches and the hammers. Hello Handsome with this like kind of metro dandy mustache. Father's Day, love this guy. This is great for anniversaries. Lots of fun masculine themes here. But if you're not into this or you don't have a use for this, don't let it deter you from looking at the All That Dies. We're going to use this little arrow piece right here. It cuts out, love this guy, but we're just going to cut it out of basic white and use it for the It's a Good Day sentiment from Hello Ladybug. So in this die set, you have a big circle with like a bottle cap edge, a wonderful label, an oval and rectangle that all have a embossed detail around the edges, two curvy banners, two straight banners, and then these argyle pieces, which are so awesome. So if this doesn't appeal to you, that's okay if you don't have a use for it, but take a look at the dies. You don't have to get bundled. You can just get one, the other, but if you get both, you save 10%. All right, so now let's get our It's a Good Day greeting and more Memento Tuxedo Black. We're gonna stamp that way off to the pointy side of our arrow, to the left side. And let's see if I can get it centered. I've got a phone right in between my hands and my eyes. I'm gonna do my best. Ooh, it is a good day. Turned out perfect. Let's get this ink out of here and bring in a scrap of Petal Pink and some Petal Pink ink. The flowers that we're about to stamp are also from Hello Ladybug. Let's ink those up. We're gonna go color on color. Give them a stamp. Beautiful. And I'm gonna cut out the largest and the smallest flower. I'm just gonna use my paper snips and give them a bubble cut. You don't need that middle size one, unless you wanted to wrap your candy bar with some designer series paper and add a flower onto the design. I thought about it last night as I was drifting off to sleep. I was like, I'm gonna wrap that candy bar with some designer series paper and put that last flower on the wrapper with one of those extra sprigs from making the Hello Ladybug class packets. And then I woke up and I got to work and I did a bunch of stuff and then I started this video and then I forgot all about wrapping my candy and designer series paper until this very minute. Isn't that funny? So if you wanted to, you can take some of that 6x6 designer series paper and just wrap a smidgy bit around your candy and add this little flower with one of the leaves on that package. Really over the top packaging as it is, but if you wanted to take it even more over the top by decorating inside, you could do that. It's about the joy of crafting, isn't it? And be a sweet surprise for your receiver too. All right, let me just trim out this other little flower. And there we are now. I've got a candy in there, don't I? Yep, let's go ahead and assemble our bits. I've got my flowers. Let's see, ladybug, my sprigs, and where did I put my greeting? There it is. I'm gonna use mini dimensionals And I'm going to start with my ladybug. She's going to go first. And I'm going to put some dimensionals on the box so that we don't glue the box closed. See, the ladybug is bigger than the box. And we don't want to go past the top edge and have exposed adhesive, or past the bottom edge of our flap and glue our box shut. So put the adhesive on the box. And then you can place your little bug. And once you got your bug placed, you can do your flowers next. And if you want just one little dimensional, or you could split a dimensional between the two if you wanted to. And then once we've got our little flowers, don't forget this one's going to hang off too. Don't glue your box closed. Then we can add "It's a good day." We're going to put one little dimensional on the tail end of the sentiment here, and then pop that over the flowers. It's okay, it's going to go over the ladybug a little bit, and it's going to go off the edge of the box just a little bit. Now that's still a little bit loose. Let's grab a glue dot and our take your pick tool, and we'll pop one little glue dot underneath the tip of the arrow here so that it doesn't swing. And then we can use our glue dots for our sprigs too. I'm going to take my glue dot and my take your pick tool. I'm going to fold the glue dot in half. And then once I've got it folded in half, it's on the end of the take your pick tool. I'm going to put it right on the stem of my sprig. Trim my sprig just a little bit. Then I'll slide it underneath. And the same with this guy. We're going to trim the stem a little bit. And roll up a glue dot. Glue dot goes on the back of our sprig. We can slide the sprig right under the greeting. Ha, I love it. Now let's embellish. I love these fun little trinkets, these loose flower flourishes. We've got a bunch of them here. You get a half a package of them in the kit, but go ahead and pick up another. They're so, so cute for embellishing. And we're going to tie the tiniest little gingham bow. So first our gingham bow, as bendy as you can get it, to make your bow smaller, hold the center knot and then pull the tails. And there's your tiny little bow. Let's cut that away from the spool with some ribbon scissors. We're back to our glue dots here. I'm going to put a glue dot on the back of the knot. Add the bow on the end of our greeting. Then I'm going to grab a big one of my flowers. I think I'm going to do the fresh freesia flower this time. Let's see how I like the look of that. We used the polished pink on our original little sample here. Cute, right? Totally overdid it with the flowers. If you wanted to replace them with something like a little pearl or something, that would be really cute too. But I can't help it. And this one just to me wanted to be over the top, so I'm going with it. I'm going to use a glue dot on the back of my large flower and just let it touch the sentiment, but don't cover your sentiment. And then for this last little glue dot on the roll here, I'm going to cut it right in half with scissors. Now I've got a half a glue dot on the discard, and I can use a little half a glue dot on my teeny little flower. Put that kind of a flower center on the stamped one. We've got the other half of the glue dot still on the roll. Pick up the little flower there. And look, now our roll's all good and tidy again. And we don't have any exposed adhesive anywhere because the dot was too big for the embellishment. All right, let's get these guys out of here. And here's our It's a Good Day Hello Ladybug Kit Kat boxes, treat boxes. If you've got any questions about the project or the upcoming Stampa Stack, you can email Marisa at kitchentablestamper.com. To shop Stampin' Up 24/7, buzz over to marisaalvarez.stampinup.net. Don't forget to get in on that free shipping. It's today only. And on Monday, May 3rd, buzz over to kitchentablestamper.com and join us for the free online Hello Ladybug Stampa Stack class. All right, you guys, if you've got any questions, reach out. I'll see you in the next video. Thanks for watching. Bye, guys.